Hello and welcome to English and News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. The news in detail. In a major cybercrime incident, an unidentified criminal siphoned off ₹12,75,000 from a man's bank account by hacking his mobile phone. The victim, Vikram Sundarlal Sethi, a resident of New Colony Chowni, told Koradi police station that he runs an industry named Sundar Industries at Smriti Nagar, Panjra, Koradi. An unidentified miscreant hacked Vikram's mobile phone recently and managed to access enough confidential data related to his bank account. Using this information, he transferred ₹12,75,000 from his bank account through RTGS system into his own. When Vikram came to know about the happening, he lodged a complaint with the Koradi police station. On the basis of the victim's complaint, Police Constable Kailash booked the unidentified cyber criminal under the relevant section of the Indian Penal Code and the IT Act, and cops have commenced a manhunt for the accused. Justice Ravi Deshpande and Justice Pushpa Ganidiwal of the Nagpur bench of the Bombay High Court visited Kasturchand Park today morning and they inspected the heritage site. During the inspection, Justice Deshpande expressed displeasure over the mismanagement and poor maintenance of Kasturchand Park. He said that special care should be taken regarding the maintenance and upkeep of the site as it is a heritage site of the city. He also asked the concerned authorities to repair the monument located on the park with urgent priority. In 2017, the High Court had taken a note of the poor state of Kasturchand Park and filed a PIL in this concern. The petition also had been pending since then. The judges highlighted that many parts of the ground has become broken and dilapidated due to the movement of a heavy vehicle on the ground. Recently, the conducting of sports activities on the ground too was prohibited. During the inspection, prominent officials from the NMC and district administration like District Collector Ravindra Thakre, Municipal Commissioner Radhakrishnan B, Advocate Sri Rang Bandarkar, Advocate Jemini Kasat, Advocate Deepak Thakre and many other officials were present. After the success of Mumbai Police Horse Mounted Unit for Traffic and Crowd Control, Minister Anil Deshmukh today said that such an initiative will be implemented in Nagpur Police too. Besides efforts to form a special investigation team, two are underway, he added. Deshmukh was speaking at the farewell ceremony of outgoing Nagpur Police Chief Dr. Bhushan Kumar Upadhyay. Incumbent Nagpur Police Commissioner Amitesh Kumar and all the officials of Nagpur Police were present on this occasion. During his address, he said the prevention measure conducted by the cops during coronavirus pandemic crisis has ensured the Maharashtra Police to achieve its all-time high image. Though while dealing with the migrant crisis throughout the lockdown period, several cops were infected and around 165 have succumbed to the disease so far. This speaks volume of the selfless deeds of our police personnel and highlighted their professionalism and dedication to duties, he asserted. A few more transfer of top officials are being planned by the Home Ministry. Once this process is over and SIT will be constituted for once this process is over an SIT will be constituted for curbing crime caused due to proper. A few more transfers of the top officials are being planned by the Home Ministry. Once this process is over an SIT will be constituted for curbing crime caused due to proper disputes. He also announced formation of a horse mounted unit to control traffic and crowd in the near future. The Kharif, Soyabean, Cotton, Orange and Mosambi crops are on the verge of being lost due to the continuous rain and outbreak of diseases like mosaic, thanali, ardhamari and brown rat. To add to this, due to coronavirus pandemic induced lockdown, farmers have been facing the extreme financial difficulties. Farmers are in trouble again this year. For inspection of various types of infection on the crops of farmers, local MLA and Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh reached the farms of riots of many villages under Kartol agricultural subdivision area and rich soybean, orange and Mosambi plantation. Soybean, loss of oranges and Mosambi crops will be taken. He thereafter reached the Regional Fruit Research Center in Kartol, Nagpur district and interacted with the farmers and agriculture officials present there. On this occasion, the Home Minister said that assessment of soybean, Mosambi and orange crops damages due to various diseases must be done soon. On Saturday, 1,741 new positive patients were reported, taking the overall tally of Nagpur to 38,139. Also, 1,347 positive patients were given discharge after their recovery. With 45 patients succumbing to the infection, the total fatality count has now gone up to 1,261. From the total 45 deaths, 35 from the city, 6 from rural and rest 4 from out of Nagpur. The tally of recovered cases has reached to 25,457, including 13,131 home isolation recoveries. The recovery rate of Nagpur after today is 66.75%. Today's 1,741 positive cases were reported from various hospitals. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with Hindi Sin News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take good and very good care of you and your family.